Hey guys, Dan from World of Mr. Grey's... World of Mr. Grey. And I want to talk about... I'm shaking my camera. I want to talk about the new Lost in Space Netflix show. I finished all 10 episodes yesterday. Took me 2 days to watch it. I enjoyed some of it. I also hated a lot of it. And I'll explain why. My main gripe with the show. First of all, I'm going to talk about the good things, right? Because there were things in there I liked. I thought it was visually impressive. The production values, I think they are amazing on that show. I think the actors they have, or the cast, sorry, they have, I think to a certain extent they are good. But I didn't like them. I'll explain why now. I thought the music was good. I liked the overall story. You know, I know it's, you know what to expect. They lost in space, but it's not just that. There are things. There are going to be spoilers in this, by the way, before I go any further, just so you know. The show wasn't what I expected. And I'll tell you why. In the trailer I saw, I think, a couple of weeks back before it came out, it showed this, you know, dark, edgy, serious, scientific, new sci-fi show. And when I saw the trailer, I thought, yes, finally, a new sci-fi show. Because Discovery's gone until next year. We gotta wait for that. I really enjoyed that. So I was looking for a new sci-fi TV show. And I watched the first episode. And the first episode, I did really enjoy. But there's a couple of things in it that's... I don't know yet, like, you know, because certain characters, which I'll get into. My main gripe with the show is the writing. I think the writing is really bad. It's really bad. Because you got this good cast. You got Molly Parker, you got Toby Stevens, you know, the villain from James Bond. Maxwell Jenkins, I'll get to him in a minute. No, the kid who plays Will Robinson. Taylor Russell. Mina Sandoval, I hope I'm saying her name right. Ignacio Cerichio. I don't know if I'm saying his name right again. Parker Posey. They're all, you know, good actors. I've only seen them in small things before, apart from Toby Stevens. Straight off the bat, I found myself disliking the cast. Not the cast, the characters, sorry. The characters they portrayed. And I think it was down to the writing, because you had the mother, the brilliant mother, controlling mother. She weren't too bad, actually, thinking about it now. She's alright. Toby Stevens, he plays the former Navy SEAL, who obviously he's the pilot in this show, where, you know, different back in the old days. But he's the pilot, and he's the action hero, get the job done, but doesn't know that much about science, which brings me to, you know, how did he pass the test? Right, Will Robinson, when he first, the first episode and probably the second episode, I thought, this kid is a really good actor. And he is a good actor. I'm not saying he's not a good actor. But then there were other parts where I thought, oh my god, he's channeling Anakin from Phantom Menace, Star Wars The Phantom Menace. And it completely took me out of it. Completely took me out of those scenes, you know, because you think, oh, he's a bloody good actor. And I, like, again, this is not down to his acting abilities, maybe, I don't think so. And I'd blame more the writing, but there were scenes in there where it was cringing. It was cringy. I know he's an 11-year-old kid, but it doesn't take away from the cringe factor of some of the scenes which Will Robinson was involved in. You got Judy Robinson, who's the medic of the family, or trainee medic. She was still sort of down to earth. They're trying to do a weird thing, if you ask me, and this could be down to casting, where they're trying to... From what I gather in the show, they're trying to pair her off with Don West, played by Ignacio Cerichio. I hope I'm saying his surname right. But it looks like they're trying to pair those two off. And it's weird because Don West seems a hell of a lot older than Judy Robinson. Which I know you shouldn't care about age, but Judy Robinson doesn't seem above age, so that's weird. I don't know her real age. I don't know what age she's supposed to be in the show, so maybe she just looks young. I don't know. I thought that was a bit weird. Penny Robinson. I have a big problem with Penny Robinson. Big problem. As far as I could tell, the woman who plays her is a good actress, but I cannot stand her character. She makes me cringe in every scene because if she's not doing sarky one-liners, every single line is a sarky, wise-cracking comment. It completely annoys the shit out of me. But if she's not doing that, there's a scene, I can't remember what episode, maybe 4 or 5, I can't remember. The kids are going through the forest with the robot, which we'll get to. And from a distance, they see this other group. And literally from 50, 100 yards away, she sees this kid about her age, I assume, 16 or something. And she immediately... I'm cringing just thinking of it. She immediately smiles as, oh, I think I'm in love. Just literally just met him. Now, I know that could happen, but so I let it slide a tiny bit as teenage lust, right? Then you get further into the show, and it's just weird. The whole thing with that character is weird, you know. She's just unrealistic, if you ask me. And Don West, the character of Don West, I think the person who plays him, he seems like a pretty good actor. This is the first time I've ever seen him in anything. And when he first, you know, I thought he's like, okay, he's the charming roguelike character. You know, they all have them, all these sci-fi shows. They all have the roguelike characters. You know, lovable rogue, so to speak. But then he immediately forms a bond with a chicken. And they play on this as well in the show. You know, he's like always with the chicken. I was like, oh, you little chicken, you, and that's weird. There's other, like, cringeworthy, and I can't go into detail too much, but my main gripe with the show is the cringeworthy writing. I think the writing is really bad. They're always in peril. There's no downtime. Anyway, when there is downtime, one of the family is in peril in some way or another. I know they're on a hostile planet and all that, but... You know, it's just like, give me a break with the peril. Enough of the peril for at least 5 minutes. Just do something normal. The science in it, I wasn't, to be honest with you, I was expecting some good science, but then at the same time, it's lost in space. It wasn't very scientific anyway. So, you know, I didn't go in there with my Neil deGrasse Tyson head on, which, you know, I haven't got. But I didn't go in there expecting, like, you know, amazing accurate science, I know, but there were some parts in there with the ice freezing over instantly and freezing up and she's trapped in you know what I mean, the very first episode scene. It was just little things like that that really annoyed me with the show, and I there was a couple of episodes where I actually fell asleep and I had to rewind because I thought, what happened there? I fell asleep. You know? And I was even in the peril moments, because even when they're in mortal danger, I found it slightly boring in some episodes. From the trailer, I think the writing is aimed towards... I know it's family friendly, but I think it's aimed way more towards kids. Which brings me to the robot. Obviously, Will Robson meets the robot in the forest. He's not the robot you see in the, you know, with the humanoid shape. He's got like 4 arms, he's got a red eye. He's like killer robots, and then, you know, you find out his backstory. But he changes into humanoid robot then with the blue face when he meets with Will Robson, you know, a friendly robot. When the robot had his 4 arms, you know, the shooters on him, it was pretty really good CGI. But then when he turned to humanoid robot, I constantly saw the guy in the suit. It sort of took me out of it. Every time the robot was on screen, I saw the guy in the suit. Even, you know, walking. He's literally walking. Trying to walk like a robot. I know he's a robot, but he's trying to walk like a robot. It's like a human person doing the robot. And so every time the robot is on screen, I can't take away from the fact that... I can 100% see the guy in the suit. and that completely takes me out of it. I'm sure that was for cost reasons, because the suit is a pretty good suit as far as a physical, prop. It's a really good suit. It still doesn't take away from the fact that I can always see the guy in the suit. I don't see the robot, I see the guy. Because if you look at the robot face, you'll never unsee this, but if you look at the robot face there, under there, you can see where the human, or the guy playing the robot, you can see his chin. It's like under a black velvet thing, but you can see his chin under the, there, and I can see that every time now. I noticed it immediately, as soon as he was in, I think it was the first episode, maybe second, and now I can't unsee it. So that takes me out of it every single time the robot's on the screen, is it's a guy in a rubber suit. Works for some things, it doesn't work in this show, if you ask me. To be honest with you, that's pretty much all I wanted to say on the show. The show, it really disappointed me. Because, like I said, the trailer is all dark and moody and serious, and then when you get to the actual show, it seemed to me like it was written for kids. Which is all fair and dandy, but the trailer told me something different. It told me it was going to be something different, and then the show turned out not to be. So I was severely disappointed in this show, personally. I know I'm in the minority again, with like everything I bloody do. Yeah, I watched all 10 episodes. It sort of redeemed itself a bit at the end. I'm not going to go into it, but it sort of redeemed itself at the end, the very final episode. And, maybe the second season will be different. I don't know, but... I forgot as well. Parker Posey. Not a fan. I'm not a fan, I gotta say. I've only seen her a few things before. I think it was Scream, like, 15 years ago or 20 years ago, something like that. She plays Dr. Smith. Spoiler alert. Not Dr. Swell. You see that in the first episode. She's not Dr. Smith. She's a criminal who's posing as Dr. Smith. But her character, where she doesn't have an agenda, it sort of tries to give her an agenda in the show with backstory stuff, but the entire time it seems like she's just being devious for devious sake. And it's like, why are you doing this? Why are you doing that? Why are you sabotaging that? It's like, they literally wrote in the script, Dr. Smith is evil. Do evil things without context. So that character annoys me. I really wanted to like this show. I really did. Like I said, there were some aspects of it I did, but there was just a lot of character choices, character dialogue, which really, really made me cringe big time. And it just took away from what the show could have been, because, like I said, visually it's so impressive. It's got, you could see it's clearly got high production values. A lot of money has been thrown to this TV show. But it just falls short for me because the characters just, they're just written wrong, if you ask me. Again, with John Robinson, the father, the ex-soldier. He's like this, gruff former soldier, Navy SEAL. And he's like, he's the man for the job. But then he does stupid stuff as well. I know, they're trying to make it, and I said this to someone earlier, they're trying to make it like an action summer blockbuster movie. You know the kind I mean. The kind you find like The Rock, Dwayne Johnson in with... What's that guy's name? I can't remember bloody hell. I can't remember his name. The cheesy one-liners and the heroic stance and the action everywhere. Coming from everywhere, no matter what. And no matter what is going on, whether your life is in danger or not, you always got a sarky one-liner. I suppose that's fine for like an hour and a half movie. Still annoys me, but I think it's fine for an hour and a half movie, but I think for a 10 episode, what I thought was going to be like a serious sci-fi show, it just grates on you after a while. The cocky one-liners, the sarcasm, I think it just misses completely in this show, and it took me out every single time. And I'm not blaming the cast. I think the cast themselves or what they're doing is pretty good. It's the writing which I blame. I totally blame the writing. It's not good, if you ask me. Or it may be, like I said, I was expecting something else, so, you know, I'm sure it's brilliant for like family friendly stuff. I was expecting something different. I don't know, that's just me, but anyway, give me your thoughts on Lost in Space. Have you watched it all? Do you think it was amazing? Do you think it was average? Do you think it was below average? I think it was just barely just touching on average, to be honest with you, because of what it could have been. But anyway, leave a like, leave a comment, whatever, subscribe if you want to hear more. Well, I do these kind of things all the time. I'd like to hear your opinions on the show, because this, as always, is my opinion. I don't speak for millions. Not yet. Anyway, hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.